Now we move to some verbs which are called as modal auxiliary verbs. Modal, they indicate the way in which the mood of the sentence changes. So we have many slides on this. In each slide, I have tried to put two or three verbs. This is a whole list of verbs which you have to remember. They have a present tense, past tense, and they also have the you know, the same form is used. Sometimes there is a present tense, you know, can and could. Could can be used as past tense of present can. But could can also be used as a separate verb, not always past tense. It can be used for future also. So, in this way, it doesn't have the tense division like other verbs have. All of them have negatives. No and not form can be added to them. They have question also. All the modal verbs have the capability of asking questions. They are not like main verbs. So, they are all question words also. Every modal verb is a question word also. So, I have given you the usage of the verb, the negative and the question form in each of the slides. And I have also written to you, written next to it, what use this has. Can has two uses. One is capability. That means, can we do something? Very often I hear students using the word, I can able to speak English. Can means able to. Able to means can. So, you are saying two times. We can't use same word two times. No, buy one, get one free. Not like that in English. No free. So, you can say, I can do it. Or, I am able to do it. I can learn it, English. I am able to learn English. Not, I can able to learn English. That is a mistake, very common mistake it's made. So, capability. Can is the word for capability. But alone, without able to. Capability without the use of the word able to. Can only alone is capability. Then you have another use of can, and that is permission. You know, you can come, you can do this, you can help, permission. Therefore, we have to see that the usual way in which we use can, ability, negative ability, and questioning that ability, these are the most common uses of can. So, wherever you want to use this ability, you have to add can to the helping, to the main verb. Can is always an auxiliary verb. It cannot, I can English, not possible. You have to have some main verb. I can read English, I can write English. So, read and write, these are the main verbs. Can does only helping function. Other than helping function, modal auxiliary verbs do not have anything else. But they indicate separate meanings, so we have many modals. Alright, now let us see all these words, all these sentences which we have here. I can speak in English.
I can speak in English.
We can learn new skills.
We can new learn skills.
He can take my brother.
He can take my brother.
And sister to school.
And sister to school.
I can solve this problem.
I can solve this problem.
So, can you see all the sentences have verbs? Speak has can speak. Learn, can learn. Take, can take. Solve, can solve. So, all of them are showing capability. You can easily see that. Can take my brother and sister can also be permission. You know, you can easily say that he can where that means you are allowing that person to take your brother and sister to school. So that is permission. I cannot help you.
I cannot help you.
That means negative capability. I have no capability. I cannot help you. That word. Again, it has contracted form. Informal, short form. I can't help you.
I can't help you.
They cannot swim.
They cannot swim.
They can't swim.
They can't swim.
She cannot run fast.
She cannot run fast.
She can't run fast.
She can't run fast.
They cannot wait.
They cannot wait.
They can't wait.
They can't wait.
Again, can you see? Verbs are there. What is the verb in the first sentence? Help. So, can't help, cannot help. Next sentence? Swim. So, can't, cannot, swim, can't swim. Then next one?
Run.
Run. Very good. So, run is cannot run, negative. And then?
Wait.
Wait. So, we have again the form, and that is the verb with the helping verb can. Can you repeat the words?
Can you repeat the words?
Can you understand this?
Can you understand this?
Can you give me some money?
Can you give me some money?
So, can you see verbs are there in this also? Can is questioning, but there is a verb here. What is the verb in the first one? Repeat. Repeat is the verb. If you look at it, can you repeat? Structure also is very important. There we are saying, I can repeat. But we are not saying, can repeat you. We are saying, can you repeat? So, subject comes in the middle of the two verbs. Verb is can, verb is repeat. Can is helping verb, repeat is main verb. In question, subject comes in the middle. So, we say, can you repeat? What is the next sentence verb? Understand. And then the last one?
Give.
So, can you understand? Can you give? These are all asking the ability, sometimes permission. Can you give? It can also be, you know, you are seeking something from another person. Then we have could. As I told you, in some places, could can be used as past of can. One use of could is past of can. But there is one more use also. Could can be used for polite request. You know, suppose I am coming on the way, then I say, could you show me the classroom? I don't know this building. So, I come and ask you, polite request, could you show me the classroom? There could is not past. That means you are not going to show the classroom yesterday. You have to show in future. If I ask you now, after 1 minute you have to show. That means it is not limited to past. It can be over present and future also. One of the uses is past. You know, I could not speak English when I was young. I had to learn English like you. I had to work hard. I was not born, my mother tongue is not English. I was not born first language speaking English. I learned English as third or fourth language, not first. Therefore, you can understand that that is a negative capability. If I say, I could not, that means past. When I was young, now I am very old. So, many years back, I could not speak. That is the past usage. But past is not the always the way in which it is used. So, you can see some sentences are there. Everywhere you will find verb is there also. For every sentence, could is only a helping verb. You must remember this very much because maximum mistakes are made when we are using the wrong form of the main verb and the wrong form of the helping verb.
We can learn new skills. He can take my brother and sister to school. I can solve this problem. I cannot help you. I can't help you. They cannot swim. They can't swim. She cannot run fast. She can't run fast. They cannot wait. They can't wait. Can you speak the words? Can you understand this? Can you give me some money?
Could you make less noise?
Could you find me a pet?
Could you find me a pet?
Now we move on to the next two verbs, and that is may, which has possibility, one of the uses. May means it might or it might not. Might is little possibility, may is bigger possibility. So when we use may, we say possibility. When we use might, we say remote possibility. They are not used as past tense, present tense of each other. They have a tenseless form because they are modals. And also a request or a permission, again we can use the form may. May can be used for request, like can. You want to, you're waiting at the door, you say, may I come in? You see on the police board it is written, may I help you? That means they are asking for, that is for asking polite request. That is what they are doing. Permission, polite request, all these things. Could and may, they can be used. English is a very polite language. So there are various ways of saying polite. If we want to say please, we can say please also. Please also is polite request. Similarly, could can be used in certain sentences. May might not be correct, could will be correct. Okay? Suppose you say, could I come in? That is not correct, because there it seems as though you are using could for something which is not going to happen at all. Okay? Whereas choice is there. Only when you are asking for permission, there is no choice. If somebody says, may I come in, you must always answer yes. You can't say no, you don't come in. Whereas if you say could, both possibilities are there. So could you give me money? So no, I can't give you money. Yes, I can give you money. So like that, certain differences are there, but their usage, sometimes their usage overlaps. Okay? So we have that. Examples are all there. I'll read. Please read with me. Might has remote possibility. It has negative form also. And might is usually not used in a question. So I have not used the question form. Whereas may is used in the question form also. So all of them are there. When you are reading the sentences, keep 100% concentration on the sentence. Try to analyze word by word what grammar we are using. Did you understand? Don't concentrate only on the yellow color. I have put in yellow color. Have you seen? What we are highlighting is in yellow. What we are learning is in yellow. But the full sentence has grammatical items. Don't miss out all the grammar. You must not look at only one aspect. You must look at the full sentence. That is how we learn. So when you are reading, please concentrate fully. Usually what happens when we have drill is you are thinking of something else and you are just reading. Reading is mechanical. I don't want you to read like that. When you are reading, put your full mind into it. It may rain today. That means possibility is there. You know, weather report. They said thunderstorm in Hyderabad for 3 days. No thunderstorm. So much heat is there today, isn't it? You may take leave tomorrow.
You may not appeal for tomorrow.
See, this is permission. You know, somebody is telling you, you may take leave tomorrow. He may not appear for the exam.
He may not appear for the exam.
He mayn't appear for the exam.
He mayn't appear for the exam.
They may not agree with the proposal.
They may not agree with the proposal.
They mayn't agree with the proposal.
They mayn't agree with the proposal.
Please notice that every sentence has a verb also. That verb should be important for you. May I come in?
May I come in?
May we begin the project?
May we begin the project?
Now we have might, only the might form and the might not form I have used. They might come.
They might come.
For the picnic.
For the picnic.
If they are free.
If they are free.
He might give you.
He might give you.
some money if he has any left. It might be very cold in the north
this year.
We might not like his suggestion. We mightn't like his suggestion. She might not get this job. I'm sorry, I read it wrong. She mightn't get this job. Now we come to two more verbs, and that is must and should. Again, should can sometimes be used as past tense of shall, but not always. Main should is for giving suggestion. If somebody says you should do this or you should not do this, that is they are giving you some suggestion, some advice. Whereas if you want to give strong advice, that means something is compulsory, you have to do it, then you would say must. Must means force is there, compulsion is there. Whereas should is very gentle. If somebody says you must come, that means you are forced to come. If they say you should come, that means choice is there. You can come or you need not come. Like that, both of them are used. I have used the word form, the negative form, and the question form. Both of these verbs have all three forms. They have the basic modal form, they have the negative form, and they also have the question form. Okay, please read. You must attend all the classes. We must complete the assignment today. She must not delay any longer. She mustn't delay any longer. They must not hesitate. They mustn't hesitate. Must you do such a terrible thing? You should listen to her advice. We should try to do. Some social service. Children should not hurt animals. The word is hurt. Not hurt, but hurt. Okay? Children should not hurt animals. Children shouldn't hurt animals. He should not accept this offer. He shouldn't accept this offer. Should we work together for this event? Sorry, that is wrong intonation. Should we work together for this event? Now we come to two more verbs. They can function in two ways. One is that they are used as helping verbs to make the future. We have in English past present only from the verb. Future has to be made by adding another helping verb. So that helping verb can be will or shall. For second and third person to make future, we use will. For first person means I and we. Second and third person is you and he, she, it and they. So for those, second person you use will, first person you use shall. That is called future. No difference, no modal. No mood is there. The mood comes when you have promise. If you use first person will, I will teach you if I say, that means I am promising to teach you. I am making a promise that I will do it. Similarly, you shall do, that means compulsory. Like we said, must. Similarly, the word shall for second and third person. He shall or you shall. No, he shall answer the police. So the police are asking, he doesn't want to speak, you say he shall answer. So what does it mean? It means that there is compulsion to do it. He has to do. There is no escape. Whereas shall for first person is simple, no compulsion, only simple future. Whereas second and third person meaning changes. This is difference is there in British English. In the rest of the world English, not much of this difference is there. Okay? Let us read. The first is the future form. They will visit Hyderabad next year.
They will visit Hyderabad next year.
You will join college in June.
You will join college in June.
These have negative forms also, question forms also. No place on the slide, so no examples. Please make examples yourself. Instead of saying they will visit Hyderabad next year, we can say they will not visit Hyderabad next year. Or they won't. Will not becomes W-O-N-T. They won't visit Hyderabad next year. Question if you want to say, will they visit Hyderabad next year? That is the question form. Like that you can make all sentences yourself. Now promise, see examples. Please repeat. I will take you to the doctor.
I will take you to the doctor.
We will inform your boss that you are ill.
We will inform your boss that you are ill.
We will not tell anyone your secret.
We will not tell anyone your secret.
We won't tell anyone your secret.
We won't tell anyone your secret.
Similarly, shall, the future first. I shall visit Hyderabad next year.
I shall visit Hyderabad next year.
We shall join college in June.
We shall join college in June.
Then we come to compulsion, second and third person. He shall return your property immediately.
He shall return your property immediately.
You shall obey me.
You shall obey me.
They shall not create trouble.
They shall not create trouble.
In this city.
In this city.
They shan't create trouble.
They shan't create trouble.
In this city.
In this city.
Now, question also you can make with shall. You know, where you are using shall by saying he shall return the property, shall he return, you can use the form. Usually in question we avoid shall. Will is more popular for making questions. Shall is not very commonly used. And in other varieties of English, the difference between shall and will, as in British English, is not so prominent. Okay, then we come to the next word. Then that is would, often used as past tense of will. Just now we saw will. I told you should, sometimes use past tense of shall. Similarly, and also would is used for permission. Again, see, again one more form where you are using for polite request, for asking permission, for asking people for something, then you can use it. How many ways of expressing the same thing? If you want to express the same thing, see, one thing when I was making you speak, one thing I realize is that you don't have anything in your mind to speak. No ideas come to you. When I say speak, you must immediately get 100 ideas to speak. Then only you will get a chance. So you look around and you speak. There are bright lights. Can't you speak about them? There is a board. Can't you speak about it? There is a hall. Can't you speak? Look at the construction of the hall. Up to there, you have tiles. Floor, you have marble. Ceiling, you have nice design. You are not looking. You are. How will you use language? Language is only the medium for your ideas. Unless you have idea, if you keep saying, I am so and so, then every day I can come and tell you, my name is this, and go away. Isn't it? That is not important. Who you are, what you are doing, that is not important. Today is the third day. That means course is finishing. Now I don't want to know your name. First day I wanted to know your name. Today I don't want to know your name. Today I want to know whether you can describe anything in English. So that is important. 3-4 only described something else. The rest of you started speaking yourself about yourself. That is not good enough. Do you understand? So that is where we have to practice. Unless you practice these things, where would can be used for past of will, unless you speak, how will you know? Suppose you describe Salar Jung Museum, or do you describe Golconda Fort? Have you seen? Tangband. Have you seen? All of you are in Hyderabad or you are in some other place? When you have come to Hyderabad, you describe. Otherwise, describe your native village. Suppose you come from a village, I have not seen your village. You describe that, I will be happy. When he was telling me about himself, I said, don't tell, tell about Malaysia. I have been to Malaysia, it's a beautiful country. But he described, see how many ideas came to him. Otherwise we say, my name, my profession, my course, my family, finished. Four sentences, life is over. Your life is not like that. It has to be, you must know everything about everything. Then only you can speak. Spoken English doesn't come by learning English. Spoken English comes by how much awareness you have. Do you know what is happening in the world? Do you know what is happening around you? Then only you can use could, should, would, shall. Otherwise you can't use. These words which you are learning, I wanted you to practice them by speaking. Nobody did. I was disappointed. I have taught you so many slides, you know. We must have 20-30 slides we have seen. No slide information has come out in your talk today. Except one slide where I said self. That everybody has learned. I want to become an IAS officer. So what? That is what I gave. That is my idea. I don't want you to be, you know, Xerox machines of my idea. That is called in genetics cloning. So we have all clones only, no individuals. So don't be like that. Think, use these words, then only you will know how they are used. Okay, please read after me. He said he would consider our request. Here it is used as the past tense of will. He said he would consider means he will consider our request. So you are putting it in he said, then it becomes past tense. She would offer suffer silently.
She would often suffer silently.
We would not hurt anyone intentionally.
We wouldn't hurt anyone intentionally.
They would not guess your purpose. They wouldn't guess your purpose. Would you offer shelter? To this homeless person? Now need implies necessity. Rarely it is used. Need can be used both as lexical verb and as auxiliary verb. In this slide only auxiliary usage. Otherwise, I need a pen, I need a book, I need a English class, I need a house, I need a job. All that is lexical use of need. Need has auxiliary use also. Okay? I need to rush to work. You need to be more disciplined. He needs to be unselfish. We need not rush to work today. We needn't rush to work today. They need not come here in a hurry. They needn't come here in a hurry. Need we wait till the end? Need you speak so rudely? Then we have the verb used. Used very often is wrong. You know, if you say, I used to know English, that means now you forgot. Whatever is used is in the past, now it is not useful anymore. Whatever is finished already, that only we say used. Present things we cannot say used. Similarly, ought. Ought is something we should do, obligation. You know, when we need to help society, many of you said we want to help society. So we say we ought to. Ought to is the ability to do an obligation, to do a duty. So this is past habit, present we are not doing. That means whatever you say, now at present this is not happening. This verb, the main verb, whatever the main verb indicates, that action is finished. That finished action only used to shows. Many times it is used wrongly by saying, I used to live in Hyderabad. Now where do you live? I still live in Hyderabad. Then why are you saying I used to live in Hyderabad? Now are you living in Delhi or Bangalore? No, no, I'm still living in Hyderabad. Then don't use used to. Used to means you stopped doing it. Now you are doing something else. Okay? I used to live in Warangal last year. We used to play here.
We used to play here.
When we were young.
When we were young.
That means play, now we don't play. Did you understand? That is the meaning here. She used to recite these lines.
You used to recite these lines.
In childhood.
In childhood.
She used to knit.
She used to knit.
Before she became old.
Before she became cold.
He used to be an athlete.
He used to be an athlete.
In his 20s.
In his 20s.
Look at the way 20s is written. Many people write 20 and then put apostrophe and they write S. That is not correct. 20s here means plural of 20. Where 20 apostrophe S comes, that means it should be some possessive form. So if I say this is the 20s team or this is a 20s movie, I am putting another noun behind it. So immediately 20 apostrophe S. Are you able to follow? Wherever it is plural, no apostrophe should be used. Wherever it is possessive, only apostrophe should be used. So we are learning punctuation, we are learning spelling, we are learning vocabulary, we are learning grammar. But you will learn all this only if you practice on your own for the rest of your life. Not one day, 1 year, 1 minute, not like that. It has to be, language has to be practiced for the rest of your life. You have to go on practicing. You'll improve, become better, better and better. Go on becoming. There is no limit to your achievement. Okay? They used to do manual labor.
They used to do manual labor.
In their youth.
In their youth.
We ought to care for our old parents.
We ought to care for our old parents.
They ought not to object.
They ought not object.
They ought not to object.
They ought not to object.
To good suggestions.
To good suggestions.
They oughtn't to object.
They oughtn't to object.
To good suggestions.
To good suggestions.
Now dare is again another modal, which means a challenge. Usually, very rarely it is used. Also, it is something where you require a noun, it becomes modal. You remove, you require a verb, it becomes modal. You don't use the verb, then it becomes the main verb. I dare to solve this mystery.
I dare to solve this mystery.
He dares to question his superiors.
He dares to question his superiors.
Say question, question.
Question.
Question. It's not question. Okay? Question.
Question.
It's not question, it's que, que.
Question.
Ka, va, a, que.
Question.
Question. He dares to question his superiors.
He dares to question his superiors.
Question is not the correct word. Que.
Question.
Question. Question.
Question.
Question.
Question.
Question.
Question.
Okay. We dare not go out.
We dare not go out.
In such bad weather.
In such bad weather.
We daren't go out in such bad weather.
We daren't go out in such bad weather.